When we talk about nutrition in the cradle, we envisage a little cute little thing lying in the cradle. And what we need to understand is that this cute little thing, जिसको हम चुन्नु मुन्नु ओ मेरा स्वीटो कहते हैं, has its own needs which we need to know and look into, because poor nutrition in this early age increases, as Shiva was saying, that it increases the risk of developing non-communicable diseases such as asthma, diabetes, obesity, and later on in life, maybe heart disease as well. And if we have adequate nutrition in the cradle and the first 2 years of life, it has a profound effect on the child's development. So what do we say? We say genetic hai ji, genetic hai. But there is a complex interplay between our genes and the environmental shape that our individuals develop. You know, interestingly, it is only a mere 20% of genetic material which affects our health. This, however, 80% over here is the impact that is maximum, and this is the environmental impact, and this includes nutrition and lifestyle as well. So more importantly, evidence seems to suggest that the way we develop during our early life can influence the way we respond to external stimuli in life. So nutrition, as we say, is a very important early life impact on what? On physical growth, yes, we all know, but we need to remember that it also has an impact on the cognitive development, on the immune maturation, on the development of digestive system, and the development of healthy eating habits. What I will like to more emphasize is that as the child develops, he adds 1 gram every day to his brain growth. And we need to understand that it is the visceral fat that is very important. And it is not the total body amount of fat, but it is where the fat is distributed, how it is distributed in our body, that affects long-term risks of metabolic and cardiovascular disease. So when we talk about early nutrition, we talk about the first 1,000 days of the baby and the mother's life. So how is it 1,000 days? It is 270 days in the womb. It is 365 days of the first year and 365 days of the second year. So that is the first 1,000 days of the child's life. And this, from conception to the second birthday of rapid growth and development, has a very significant effect on our lives. And the nutritional aspects, if the right nutrition is there, it is crucial to fuel our growth and development. So what you eat in these first 1,000 days can positively or negatively influence and have long-term side effects or effects. So when we say the first 1,000 days, you can just see over here, this is up to 24 months, the maximum growth faltering takes place over here. So it is very important. I cannot emphasize over as much how important it is. So too few children, if I say, this is a percentage of 45% who is not starting early initiation of breastfeeding, 43% there is no exclusive breastfeeding, 64% there is introduction of solid, semi-solid, only 64% by 6 months of age. This is a global data, and so on and so forth, where we find that there is a deficiency which is coming up by 2 years of age. So optimal nutrition is not there when we are talking about the first 1,000 days. And what is it actually resulting in? It is actually resulting in stunting, wasting, micronutrient deficiencies, and overweight or obesity, which is also now called a deficiency and not a healthiness. Bahut glaxo baby bolte the, it is no more that way. So when I talk about such things, this is the global data. What about India? when we talk about India, remember, 36.1 of the districts of India have shown stunting prevalence of 40% or more. And not only stunting present in India, but there are glaring disparities and unacceptably high stunting in certain states. So we need to be very, very careful. And as I said, the mother's diet does matter. A healthy and a balanced diet before conception and during pregnancy will help nourish the fetus and get optimal body reserves. So we need to concentrate on the body reserves as well. And furthermore, evidence now shows that if there's an imbalance of macro or micronutrients during pregnancy, it can program a child to develop non-communicable diseases. Why I'm putting so much of importance? By 16 days, you see, most of the brain's connections are established in the first few years. By 16 days after conception, the neural tube starts establishing itself. And by the 30th week, the nerve cells branch out and connect to each other to form the basic pathways of neurology. Now, this process continues until birth, and the brain grows to about a quarter of the adult size by the 2 years of age at least. And as such, it is important that all pregnant mothers get extra care to ensure that their nutritional intake covers all the necessary ingredients. Now, vital nutrients, I cannot stress more and more on this. You all know that we need the vitamins D, B2, B6, B12, folic acid, so on and so forth for the mother so that she develops these reserves. So, up till now, I have been talking about the mother's diet. But when you talk about the breastfeeding, remember, breastfeeding, it is very, very important now by 0 to 6 months. Breastfeeding. So what is happening about breastfeeding? Because the human milk, we all know, is the most important source for all infants. It contains the right balance of nutrients and a bioactive components to ensure that there is an optimal growth and there's a development of the body, of the organs, including the immune system, the GIT, and microbiota. Another important part which is coming up these days in research is the gastrointestinal microbiota, which actually is related to our immune system. Now, in addition, many long and short-term health problems arise if the child is not properly breastfed. So what about the, now I'm talking about the baby, so what about the mother? Remember, the nutritional impact on lactation is much more than in pregnancy. So there are higher requirements of many things for the mother, like vitamin B12, B2, zinc, vitamin B6, and iodine, vitamin A, etc. in lactating mothers. So after birth, it is not only important to look at the child's breastfeeding, but it is also important to look at the mother's breastfeeding. Now, this is what is very disheartening. The NFHS 5 data has recently been released on December 20th. And you can see here, it states that early initiation of breastfeeding has declined in 12 states and union territories. It is recommended practice, but and we all know that it prevents around 20% of neonatal deaths. But the share of children who are actually receiving it is getting lower. And in Mumbai, they have said that only 51% were breastfed within the first hour, though 99.5% were institutional deliveries. Not only that, according to this data, phase one survey, there's been a decline in early breastfeeding in as many as 12 out of 22 surveyed states and union territories. And the anticlimax here, as I said, is that they were all institutional deliveries. So the importance of complementary feeding. Now we must start at 6 months, and looking into the stunting and the wasting, we need to have a frequency and diversity while providing our food or complementary feeding to these children. If appropriate complementary practices are there, we can actually prevent 1 lakh deaths in children under 5 each year. So that is not a very low number for us. You can see here why we need complementary feeding, because the energy gap, as the age of the child increases, the energy gap actually starts increasing. And by 12 to 23, the breast milk is, the energy gap is so big that the breastfeed is not adequate to take care of the energy needs of the child. You can see here the iron gap also. The iron gap keeps on increasing and increasing, and the child gets inadequate share of iron, which is a very important factor also. Now, only 1 in 4 children is eating the food from the minimum number of food groups. As the diversity talk I was saying, I was talking about diversity. There are about 5 food groups from which the child should be taking food. But 1 in 4 is eating. Agar chawal kha raha hai, toh chawal hi kha raha hai. Agar alu kha raha hai, toh alu hi kha raha hai. So they are not actually covering all the 5 food groups. And therefore, the children are not eating good food. So when we talk about solid food introduction, you must remember that milk alone now is no longer adequate. The introduction is to develop the tastes, the preferences of the child. And this is the foundation where you are laying for healthy eating habits. So this phase is actually very, very important when you are providing energy to the food and choosing the right type and variety of complementary food exposes these babies to a right variety of taste and textures. I'll talk about the taste and textures, which are very, very important. And that actually helps in establishing healthy food habits and lifelong food habits. So when I talk about these food, remember that if your child is ready to eat, then you need to know that also. By 6 months of age, if the child can sit up with minimal support, and aapko dekhe na, he is munching, his mouth is going up and down, and he's showing interest, aapke plate mein haath maar raha hai, and he can control his tongue and neck movements, that is the time when he is ready to eat. And remember that it should be baby led, because we have, for a very newborn, we have the rooting reflex, then we have the tongue thrust reflex, and the suck swallow pattern should have established, the gag reflex. So we need to actually remember that if we do not introduce food at the right time, it will not promote the reflexes. And therefore, jaise 8-9 mahine tak agar aapne usko particulate matter nahi diya, so what is going to happen, his chewing reflex is not going to develop, and that child will definitely have only mixi kiya hua food till maybe 5 years to 7 years of age, and you're going to run from pillar to post to provide the right nutrition to that child. It should be enjoyable, as I said, and you should gradually increase. Force feeding is absolute no. Khale bachcha, khata nahi hai bachcha, thoos do bachcha. That is not to be done. Not to be done in front of a television ki zyada khalega, kam khaa raha hai mera bachcha. Never, never force feed a child, and increase the feeding gradually. Ek feed, phir do feed, phir teen feed, is tarah se the child, and try one food at least 5 to 7 times every time before you reject that food ki बच्चा ये नहीं खाता है. Remember, the child will preferentially gradually develop a taste. कई बार mothers will come and tell you, मेरा बच्चा खाता नहीं है, कुछ खाता नहीं है. So if you are giving milk हर बार, आपने बोतल मुंह में ठूस दिया, तो चाइल्ड विल नेवर एक्सेप्ट द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फीड्स. सो देयर आर सेवरल थिंग्स. यू आर डिस्ट्रैक्टिंग द बेबी, कोई किसी और से बात कर रहे हो, कोई गाना बगल में बज रहा है, तो चाइल्ड विल बी डिस्ट्रैक्टेड. ही विल नॉट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन हिज फूड, ही विल कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन द डिस्ट्रैक्शंस. नॉट ओनली दैट, बच्चा थक गया है, एंड यू फोर्सिंग द चाइल्ड टू हैव फूड. सो रिमेंबर द रेगुलर नैप टाइम्स, इफ यू हैव देम, दैट विल मिनिमाइज एनी प्रॉब्लम्स विद न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ योर बेबी. एंड remember, if the child is not feeding well, prick up your ears, the child may not be well. सबसे पहले बच्चा क्या छोड़ता है? खाना छोड़ता है अगर वो unwell होता है. So consult your doctor and see, look for possible signs कि उसको temperature तो नहीं है, उसको कोई और problem तो नहीं हो रही है. So that is one thing that we need to look into. So when we're talking about taste and textures, पहले हम लोग कहते थे क्या कि fruits पहले add करो. But now what we say, the recent recommendation is that you add vegetables first. Why? Because fruits are always sweet. मीठा होता है, बच्चे accept कर लेता है. But veggies may be bitter. And the acceptance of this taste has to be learnt. So vegetables are to be introduced first. And remember, texture is one of the main reasons of rejecting food, both in adults and in children. And the child needs to learn कि ये वाला टेक्सचर हमें लेना है, ये हेल्दी फूड है, एंड हैज टू लर्न थ्रू कॉम्प्लेक्स टेक्सचर्स एज वेल, एंड देयरफॉर दिस शुड बी डन एज सून एज द चाइल्ड इज डेवलपमेंटली रेडी, एंड दैट इज द फर्स्ट ईयर वेयर इट इज अ क्रिटिकल विंडो वेयर यू हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस डिफरेंट टेस्ट एंड टेक्सचर्स. If this opportunity is missed, remember, the child will suffer, you will suffer along with the child, and the child will not accept the regular food. Not only that, if you do not introduce, as I said, by lumpy food by 9 to 10 months, the child will have feeding difficulties at 15 months of age, or fir aap, you will be consulting pediatricians like me, ki bachcha khata nahi hai, kaise karke kare, the nutrition part is not adequate, mujhe to isko mixi karke khilana padta hai, usme bhi muh mod leta hai. So there are feeding difficulties which are associated with these food not being accepted by the child. Now, when we think about appearance of food, remember, that is also a very, very important aspect where you are giving, providing nutrition to the child. And preferentially, maine yahan lal dikhaya hai jaan karke, because the child has a preference towards the color red. So remember, at 2 years, a child can categorize foods based on similarity, and color is an important aspect for that categorization as well. So appearances also matter. And when we talk about supplementary food, kya karte hain? Sabse pehle question aata hai, madam gaay ka doodh pila dein kya? But remember, cow's milk under 1 year may cause a lot of problems. So do continue breast milk, and advise your clients to continue breast milk, because it will cause iron deficiency anemia, it may cause gastrointestinal blood losses, and it has an excessive renal solute load, and the immature kidneys are unable to handle this. So mother's breast milk cannot be emphasized as much as possible, because cow's milk less than 1 year is not recommended now. Now about one small thing, mera bachcha bahut doodh nikalta hai. So regurgitation is another very prominent problem. And kai baar hota hai ki when a gastroenterologist, peed gastro wala, jab usko endoscopy karta hai, so he finds that there is an erosive esophagitis. So there is a reflux disease in these children. And remember, the reason of this may be excessive feeding or not right feeding as well. So we give advice, thicken feeds over here, so that has a effect on reduction of these regurgitation. And if there is a number of, this thickened feed is given, there is actually a reduction in the number of GER episodes. So that is one tip which I would like to give all of you. And now once the child is greater than 12 months, you can transition to the family diet. And the toddler now needs sub to say 7 times a feed, that is 3 regular meals and maybe 2-3 snacks also of specific nutrients. So per kg body weight, you know, you are dietitians as well, you know how much the child will need. And this means that every spoon should be rich in micronutrients and nutrients. So we cannot just give anything to the child, ki chips khila diya, biscuit khila diya, pet bhar gaya. Mera child to, one of the mothers came and told me ki mera bachcha to 5 biscuits savere kha leta hai, aur phir main usko ek glass gaay ka doodh pila deti hu, bas ho jata hai, lekin dekhiye doctor sahab, iski wazan nahi badh rahi hai. So a toddler has specific nutritional needs, and we always need to advise ki family diet jo bhi hai, the child should be having from the family pot. So, उस वक्त दाल का पानी नहीं, उस वक्त कोई जूस नहीं, it should always be what the family is having. Now, when we talk about the diet of the toddler again, this is a period where he is also gaining autonomy. So, other than the nutrient part, you have to understand that the child is gaining autonomy, उसकी अपनी पसंद ना पसंद develop कर रहा है, and the feeding styles of the parents has a profound impact on the child's behavior. आप टीवी के सामने बैठा के उसको खिलाओगे तो he will never develop his preferences. He will मुंह खोल के आ करके बैठ जाएगा, and you will be feeding anything to the child, and maybe later on the child may not accept that food at all. So before I finish, I tell that the impact in the first 3 years is something that is very, very great. You see over here that it is a 3 kilo baby, which becomes a 15 kilo child by the end of 2-3 years. And that is, it's gaining 5 times in weight, it's gaining 2 times in height, and it's gaining 1 gram of brain every day. तो बच्चे को फर्स्ट करना है तो आई टेल द मदर, अच्छा आपको बच्चे को फर्स्ट लाना है तो आप उसका न्यूट्रिशन क्या क्या देते हो बताओ. सो देर आर सेवरल चैलेंजेस लाइक द मटर्नल अंडर न्यूट्रिशन, लाइक द मटर्नल एनीमिया विच वी हैव बीन ट्रीटिंग, लाइक द लो बर्थ वेट दैट इज अकरिंग इन आर कंट्री एवरी डे, एंड द चाइल्ड अंडर न्यूट्रिशन विच वी आर फेसिंग. वी हैव माइक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट डेफिशिएंसीज एवरी डे, रिसर्च इज सेइंग, एंड दीज चैलेंजेस आर गोइंग टू बी मेट इफ वी एनफोर्स पोषण अभियान विच हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय on holistic nutrition by our prime minister, which is supposed to reduce the stunting, which is to prevent undernutrition, prevent anemia, and to reduce low birth weight in children. So emphasizing once again, the first 1000 days from contraception to 2 years of age, 0 to 9 months of pregnancy, then breastfeeding, exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months, and then 6 months solid food introduction, gradually one food at a time, each taste to be enjoyed, and then transition to the family pot. Thank you.